This morning, before I greet you, I want to tell you that we're going to turn the whole service upside down this morning. So be prepared for some completely different things. Okay? I want you to do something for me as we start the service this morning. I want you to find somebody next to you or anyone that is near you. I'm going to ask you, maybe Anton, that you pair up with this gentleman over here. I don't know his name. But I want you, we're going to sing a song. Ek gaan ons gaan vir oom Johan vra om vir ons 'n liedjie van Pieter Dief. Dief Burger. Vir Pieter Dief Burger en Rihanna Nell. Ons gaan 'n liedjie van hulle sing. En terwyl ons dit sing, terwyl ons dit speel, wil ek vir jou vra, luister vir my baie mooi. Ek wil hê dat jy diep in jou hart moet gaan kyk, né? Ons gaan vir julle anoint van môre dat julle profeties oor mekaar sal bid van môre. Nou, moenie dink ek is nie 'n profeet nie en almal dit jy het die gees van God in jou as jy die Here ken. En wat ek wil hê is jy moet daai wense wat jy vir jou eie lewe het, wil ek hê dat jy moet dit oorplaas op iemand anders. Lê jou hande op daai persoon en sê vir die Here, dit is jou begeerte vir hierdie persoon. OK, so seën hulle. Seën die persoon langs jou. As daar 3 van julle is, dan sit daar 3 by julle bymekaar. Maar ek sal verkies dat dit 2 van julle is, 1-1. Man en vrou, bid vir mekaar. Ek wil nou nie weet van die feit dat jy nou nie die skottelgoed opgewas het en daai tipe goed nie. Jy bid nou net die goeie dinge van die Here oor iemand se lewe. OK. Some time ago I did an experiment with a group of young people I was training. It wasn't in a church. It was at my house in a training center. And at some point in time I sensed the Holy Spirit saying to me, "Stop what you're doing." And let them turn to each other. And let them start to bless each other. Like we've just done. And I'm going to say to you, just a couple of minutes into it, there was tears flowing. Later on, some of them came back and said, "You know, Wesley, no one has ever blessed me like this. My mother didn't bless me. My father didn't bless me. I'm telling you today, my friend, it is lacking. Yes, your children may be a problem to you. Maybe they're doing everything opposite to what you have been teaching them. Despite that, I want to say to you in the name of Jesus that you need to bless them. Bless them. Anoint them and bless them despite their problems, despite their disobedience. I want to say to you, this is what God is doing amongst us." En daar, jy kan gaan lees daar, wat sê, dit is in Numeri hoofstuk 6, en vers 24 en 25, sê die Here vir Moses, soos ek voorheen gesê het, hy sê vir Moses en Aaron, "Gaan seën my volk, seën hulle." En dit is wat ek met jou wil deel vanmôre, jy is geseën. Nou vanmôre, as jy nou reg geluister het, na die persoon wat oor jou gebid het, en jy hoor wat hulle sê, wat het aan jou siel doen, kan net jy en die Heilige Gees oorgetuig. Hoe maak dit jou voel? Dit roer iets binnen jou. As iemand begin spreek oor jou, en profeteer oor jou, dit is wat die Here vir ons roep na. En vanmôre wil ek vir jou sê dat jy is geseënd. You are blessed. You are blessed. Ephesians chapter 3, 1 and verse 3. It says very clearly, "Blessed is the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who has blessed you with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. God has already blessed you. Before you knew it, when you were still deep in your sin, when you didn't want to hear anything from God, when you did not, when your ear was turned away from Him, as jy moest kies of jy kerk toe gaan, of jy na Sewende Laan gaan kyk, dan gaan jy Sewende Laan kyk. Alles is net een klomp nonsens wat hulle vir jou leer daar. Maar ek wil vir jou sê, ten spuite van wie jy is, en die situasie waarin jy jou bevind, het die Heere jou al reeds gesien. Halleluja! En met dit wil ek vir julle groet. Ek wil vir julle sê, julle is gesien. Voor ek vir julle hello sê, I want to tell you, I want to greet you in the precious name of Jesus. Jesus has got such a powerful name. He's got the name above every name, the Bible says. For at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. So it is a real privilege for me, simple guy, to come and greet you in that precious name. Christmas Fellowship, our topic for the month is to seize the moment. Make full use of the opportunity. En soos die Afrikaner sê, as die pap val, kom. Kom julle met, odou, ek is I'm an African, and I need you to talk to me. I can't have you to sit like you in another place. Come and talk to me. As die pap val, skep. Of was hulle bang om te skep? Dis vir nie. Die Heere geer het vir jou vir vry. So as die pap val, skep. Toe die man aan die woestijn geval het, het niemand gesê, moet ons of moet ons nie, gaan ons of gaan ons nie. Hulle het gehol, hulle het gehardloop. En hulle het gevat, soveel soos hulle wil. En die Bybel sê vir ons, hulle wat baie gevat het, dit was genoeg. En hulle wat min gevat het, dit was ook genoeg. So ek sê vir jy hier vanmorgen, as die genade van die Heere val, skep. Moet nie bang wees nie. Carpe diem. Een Latijnse woord wat beteken, gryp die geleentheid. Gryp die geleentheid. En vanmorgen wil ons een bykie daar oor praat. Halleluja. Voor ons daar oor gaan praat, wil ons hee, ons moet een bykie stilstaan. En kyk, waar is ons? Hoeveel blikjes kos is in die kassie? Hoeveel brood is in die blik? Hoeveel geld is daar in die rekening? Weet julle, baie kere, toe ek en my vrou dier baie rowwe tye gegaan het, het ek altyd waar gesê, moenie, don't panic. Don't become hysterical. Let's sit down. Let's consider. Let's think about where God brought us from. Let's look back and see where God brought us so that we can understand and we can appreciate what God does. And that's what David was good at. Where are we? What is the foundations that we have? This is why in the Psalms he uses the word Selah. Laat ek stil sit. Laat ek een bykie kyk na die wolke. Laat ek kyk na die branders, laat ek een bykie my oes in die vuur en staar, en laat ek een bykie kyk na die vuur in my vrouse oe, en in my kinderkiese oe, en kyk, waar is ons? En wat gaat ons doen? En elke keer, as dit met my gebeur het, het die Heere vir my geherinner, hoe hy vir my uit situasies uitgekom haal het, wat ek gedink het, is onmoontlik. Vriende, die Heere is niemand sy skuldenaar nie. He doesn't owe anything. He's no man's debtor. He doesn't owe you anything. But the Bible says, he did these things for us because he loved us. He loves us. That's the reason. The motivation is not what he can get from you. The motivation is that he loves you despite who you are. And this morning, I've got 4 points I want to quickly share with you. That you are blessed. The first one is, God has blessed us. And I've already given you some scriptures to say that. You have been chosen. You're a chosen generation. I am so excited, I must tell you. I don't know about other people, but if I look around me, we are living in an exciting time in our history. Very exciting time. We are living in the age of information. We have access. Things are changing. Everything is changing. What happened this year turned the whole world upside down. But we come out stronger. We come out more energetic. We come out, I had to just share with somebody during the break. Because of COVID, I had to redo everything I do. I had no job, but I worked harder than I've ever worked before. Because I had purpose, I had vision, and I had to do certain things. Right? And I want to say to you, you are a royal priesthood. You are part of a chosen generation. God doesn't make mistakes, and I'm going to prove that to you tonight, this morning. I'm going to prove it to you that God does not make a mistake when he chooses you. We are a people that is separated unto God. God personally decided to separate us for himself. He has chosen us to be his people. Hallelujah. Number two, in the book of Acts, Paul speaks and he says there to the people in Acts chapter 17 and 26, he says, from one man, he made all the nations. Right? Of men, that they should inhabit the whole earth. And he determined the times set for them and the exact places where they should live. Now, I used to be very fascinated by this verse because I grew up in a township. And I used to say to myself, but why, God, did you allow me to be born in a township? Why couldn't I be born in Bishop's Court? Or Houghton. See, that's what we ask ourselves. Until somebody showed me this verse and says, you know what? Don't stress yourself about Houghton or wherever. God does not make a mistake. He has determined the times and the places where I need to live. He showed me that Jesus, the King of Kings, was born in a stable. There wasn't even a place for him. They turned him away. And he had to go into the stable. His mother had to go into a stable to be born, for him to be born. So I want to say to you, God has not made a mistake to have you here. This is where he needs you to be. I chatted to Anton earlier. I asked him, when last have you been home? Seven weeks ago. Am I right? Says now, he wants to be there, but he's here. And he need to ask himself, what is the purpose of that? If it's me, I will question that big time. Right? And I'm sure you do as well. But God has determined, the Bible says, God has set the times and determined the places for us to live. I want you to understand it because this is the basis. This is our foundation. Number one, we are blessed. Number two, God is in control of the time. And he is in control of where he's placed you to be. This is where you need to be right now. And number three, God has determined by his own will, he set out good works for us. Ephesians 2 verse 10 says, for we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. God has already planned this whole thing for us. And He wants you to be the person that He has called. He has made you in a certain way. Nobody could have predicted that you would turn out the way you do. Nobody could predict it. But this is how God's plan had fulfilled. You may say, but you don't know the disappointments in my life. XFAO, hallelujah. Want dit is waar die Here vir jou naartoe gebring het. Jy het deur al die goed gegaan, zodat die Here vir jou hierdie oomblikke kan gebruik. Dit is vir 'n tyd soos hierdie, sê die woord van die Here, dat Hy vir jou gebore laat word het, en waarom jy vandag hier is. Ek wil vir jou sê, ek wil net 'n konsep vasmaak gou in jou gedagtes, en dit ek glo, dit is hoekom baie van ons nie die oomblikke wat die Here vir ons gee, ten volle gebruik nie, want ons is 'n bietjie, ons huiwer tussen opinies, ons huiwer tussen gedagtes. Jy moet vandag, moet jy, you must make up your mind, whether you're a sinner or whether you're a saint. You can't be both. If you think you are both, then you are schizophrenic. In other words, your mind is playing games with you. You are either a sinner or you're a saint. If you're a saint, it's because God saw the sinner and He came and He sent Jesus to die for your sin so that you can accept it, so that you can become the saint that He wants you to be. Hallelujah. Baie van ons, ons dink ons kan nie dit doen nie, omdat ons nie belangrik genoeg is, of ons het nie genoeg van dit nie. Nee, jy is wie jy is. Die Here het jou gemaak wie jy is, sodat jy kan wees wie jy veronderstel is om te wees. Hou op, probeer Beyoncé wees, of Lady Gaga wees. Jy weet, dis wat jy mos nou wil wees. Jy wil soos Meghan Markle, wat is die vrou se naam? Harry Markle, Harry se vrou, ne? Jy wil nou so sy wees. Nee, wees jy die beste jy. Jy is hier omdat die Here vir jou geroep het in jou omstandighede, en jy moet wees wie jy is. En dit is wat die Here wil hê jy moet doen. You either sinner who by nature sins. If you're a, as jy 'n vis is, dan swem jy in die see. Of jy swem in die water. Verstaan jy? As jy 'n bok is, hardloop in die veld. Wag hier vir my, wag hier vir my. Dat ek jou kan skiet. Maar jy kan jouself keer, jy gaat maar net, ons lag baie vir die swart wilde beeste, want ons, we call them the clowns of the plain. Hulle hartloop rond, hulle is een klomp gekke. Hulle wacht maar net daar vir my, dat ek hulle kan skiet, dat ek een bietjie bultong kan kry. Maar dit is hoe dit is. You either a sinner that sins by nature, or you're a saint. If you're a saint, you're a sinner saved by grace. Hallelujah. And God says, when you are a sinner that is saved by grace, you're now a saint. You are no longer a sinner. You don't do the sin that you did anymore. You've left it behind. You've moved on by the grace of God. Will you sin still? Sometimes you will sin. But that is not who you really are. You are a saint. Hallelujah. And you need to understand it, because that will rob you of doing the things that God wants you to do. It will withhold you from being the person that God wants you to be. You are righteous in Jesus Christ. And let me give you some excellent news. You had to do nothing for it. The Bible says, Ephesians 2 verse 8 and 9, it says, you have been saved by grace through faith. This is not of yourself. It is a gift of God. It is not by works, so that nobody can boast. It is not something that you've done.
to earn the righteousness that God has given. You can also go and read in Romans 5, I think it's Romans 5, 38, where it says that God has given us the gift of righteousness. He's given us abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness. Hallelujah. Not for gain, but God ordained you to do it. The things that you're doing as a saint, the righteous work that you're doing is not to gain brownie points with God. You're doing it because you want to do this. This is the only way. I was listening to one of my other sermons that I preached, and I said, you do because you do. You love because you love. You don't love so that you can get something in return. This is the work that God has set out for us. And there are many things that He has asked you to do, and we will come there more. This is not for gain. What? This is what saints do. Saints, Christmas, julle is 'n klomp saints. Wat sê mense in Afrikaans vir dit?
Verlostes.
As die verlostes huis toe gaan. Ken jy die reiletjie? Ja, die verlos, as jy verlos is, dan as jy daar by President Hyper instap, nee. Luister julle, as julle by President Hyper instap, dan sal die mense sien die verskil in jou. Hulle sal het sien. Hulle sal het voel. Omdat jy kom daarin en jy het die geest van God in jou. Halleluja. Die geest is hier so. En as jy nou daar instap, dan soek jy iemand om hulle te sien. Hey! Jy soek jy iemand om hulle te kan skarrel met hulle nie. Jy wil hulle sien. En dit is wat binnen jou is. Hey, amen. En vierdens, die Heere gee vir ons sy woord en hy gee vir ons sy gees. Halleluja. Hy gee vir ons sy woord en hy gee vir ons sy gees. 2 Petrus 1 vers 3 sê, vir ons baie, baie mooi, says, God's divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of Him who called us by His own glory and goodness. God called us. As die Here jou nie geroep het nie, dan was jy nog steeds in hy gat, sê ek jou. Dan was jy nog steeds daar, saam met die varke. Maar die Here het jou geroep. Tensy die Here jou roep, gaan jy totaal nie wees wat jy veronderstel is om te wees nie. Halleluja. Sy woord, hy geef ons sy woord, en daar is baie, baie skrifte wat ek vir jy kan gee daar, maar omdat die tyd my beperk, het ek maar die enekie daar gesit, Proverbs 22 verse 17, incline your ear and hear the words of the wise and apply your mind to my knowledge. That's what the Bible says. This is what God says. Seek wisdom so that God can use you in this day. He gave us His Spirit. Beautiful verse in John chapter 14 and verse 16. He says, then I shall ask the Father, this is Jesus talking, and He says, to send you the Holy Spirit who will help you and always be with you. Hoi, vriende, skryf die op jou hart. Hy gaan vir jou die Heilige Gees gee, wat gaan doen? Hy gaan jou help. Nee? So jy is nie op jou eie nie. You're not doing this thing out of your own flesh or in your own knowledge. You're doing this with the help of the Father. And that's, we're going to come to that. But I want to just quickly recap for you. Number one, you are blessed. Say to somebody next to you, I am blessed. I am blessed. Lianke, jy is geseen. Okay, I'm blessed. Number two, say that God is in control of my life. You need to admit that. God is in control. God determined. You made the decisions, yes. Maar jy weet mos nou nie hoe die Here werk nie. Die Here se gedagte sal aan die einde sevier. Die Here laat jou dink dat dit is die beste goed vir jou en dan dis waar jy is vandag. Nommer drie, die Here het vir ons werke uitgesit voor die grondlegging
van die aarde heeft hij voor ons dingen uitgezet dat ons het kan doen. En dit is wat je moet vastmaken in je hart. En nummer vier, hij heeft voor ons zijn woord gegeven en het voor ons zijn geest gegeven. The sword of the spirit, the shield of faith. Right? The word that is ready. That's what he does. The conclusion is, if God has given you that kind of foundation, there is very little choice, people. Very little choice. You can choose not to listen to him. It's going to be at your own cost. But I want to say to you, God has set us up to succeed. God has set us up to win. In fact, he's already won it for us on our behalf. All he wants us to do is to believe it and walk in it. Step in it and walk into it. We need to seize the moment, the day, the opportunity. Carpe diem. It is a term that says, I am making full use of the opportunity that God has given me. God has set me up. He has literally set me up so that I can win. Yo, you know how that makes me feel? Tyson kan maar kom, ek sal vir hom vat. Ek sal 'n bietjie dakke daai, maar die Here sal my help met hom. Okay, and this is what I'm going to say to you today. How are we going to do that? This is the problem with carpe diem. We all have this problem, and I want to discuss that with you very briefly this morning. Why is it that we do not respond to the Spirit in the way that we should? And I want to say to you, do you know this guy, Forbes? Forbes is internationally known. His name is Stephen Forbes. He is the man that every single year comes out with the Fortune 500 recipients. Or he is the one who decides or compiles the Forbes 500 lists of the richest people in the world. And he, why am I quoting him? Because he deals with very successful people in this world. If you're a Fortune 500 company, you know that you are doing very, very well across the world. And he says, the best place to succeed is where you are with what you have. And I'm going to tell you now, you as a child of God, julle sal my mooi kyk met die blauwe oogies van julle, maar julle glo nie wat ek sê nie. Laat ek 'n bietjie klop op hierdie stuk hout. So. Jy luister vir my, maar jy glo nie eintlik wat ek sê nie. En ek wil vir jou vra, laat ons die Here toelaat om dit te verander. Jy moet begin net waar jy is. Omdat, hoekom? Omdat die Here al reeds dit besluit het, die tye waar jy sal lewe en waar jy sal woon. Die Here het dit besluit. Daarom, jy kan nie vir my sê, Wesley, jy ken nie my vrou nie, man. Jy ken nie my vrou nie. As die Here my man net 'n ander vrou gee, dan sal ons baie beter uit doen. Jy kan nie so sê nie. As die Here my man net 'n nog 'n kar gee, die kar van my kan ek nêrens mee gaan nie. Do you recognize those arguments? That's what you're saying. Before I do this, and before I do that, what God has called me for, if only God can change this, and God can change that. But I'm going to say to you, God is going to change nothing. He first wants to change your mind. He wants to change your heart. He wants you to believe him first. That's why I said to you some time ago, Matthew 6:33 says, seek first the kingdom and his righteousness. You cannot just seek the kingdom. Here, give me nog 'n kar. Here, give me nog 'n huis. Nee. You must seek his righteousness. What is his righteousness? Being born again and having Jesus inside of me, and I live my life with purpose because God has ordained it like that for me. God says, and I'm going to say to you today, the best place to succeed is where you are with what you have. Don't wait for any longer. Don't wait. Moenie wag tot jy ophou rook nie. Moenie wag tot jy ophou drink nie. Moenie wag tot jy ophou steel nie. Gee jou lewe nou. Maak die verschil nou. En dan die Heere, die Bijbel sê, die Heilige Geest gaan jou help. Want jy kan het nie op jou eie doen nie. Jy kan nie. Vraag my, ek weet, ek sien hulle. Ek gaan besoek hulle in die tronke. Ek gaan hulle besoek. En as ek met hulle praat, weet jy, broer, as het maar net so was, as het maar net, sê nee, dis nou volhaar stories. As nie, as het maar so was en so, maak een besluit vir die Heere. Wees die man, wees die vrou, en maak een besluit vir die Heere, want die Heere geef vir jou alles wat jy nodig het, om een sukses te maak. Nou, julle ken The Living Land, dit is op SABC 2, dit was eerst 5:00 in die ochtend, is een program oor die landbouw, agriculture, and they have a very famous saying, do what you can with what you have. Do what you can with what you have. Halleluja! Vandag is het dag wat die Heere vir ons gegee het. Niemand anders het vir ons gegee nie. Matamela Ramaphosa kan nie vir my een dag gee nie. Maar die Heere het vir my een dag gegee. Halleluja! En daarom sê ek vir jou, die Heere gee vir ons vandag. He has given us life. He has given us His word. He has given us His spirit. He has provided the sacrifice lamb. He has given us breath. He has given us opportunity. He blesses us with all that we need for this life. Amen. And Kersma, I'm here to ask you that you will rise. Stand up. And believe God. Because if God is with us, who can be against us? Who can be against us? Who has the audacity to stand up against this God of mine? As David says, julle skuil vir hierdie reus. Maar ek sê vir jou vandag, ek kom na jou toe in die naam van Jesus. Ek ken nie om hoe groot jy is nie. Jy sal hard val, my vriend. Want die Heere is met my. Hy het een klipje gevat en hy het die reus sy kop afgekap met sy eie swaard. En dit is wat is, He has already given us the victory. All we need to do is to step into what God has already planned for us. Krisma, is julle met my?
Amen.
Halleluja. Ek wil nie julle met julle tyd mors nie. Tyd is belangrik en tyd is kostbaar. En ek wil vir julle sê vanmorgen, ek wil julle bemoedig dat julle die Heere se woord glo, dat julle vir Jesus glo, dat julle vir hom vat, dat julle die geleentheid gebruik, by die hem. Gebruik die geleentheid. Halleluja. We need to seize the moment, the day, the opportunity, the success, the victory, the healing, the restoration, the revival, the breakthrough. We must take it for ourselves because God has already given us the victory. Hallelujah. Wat sê hy vir Gideon? Julle wat in die weken gekyk het na die klip van woensdag, het ek 'n bietjie gesels oor Gideon. Waar Gideon weg gaan kruip het in a wine press. To thresh his wheat. When the angel of the Lord appeared to him, and the angel of the Lord challenged him, he says, mighty warrior. He says, what? I'm a mighty warrior. How can you call me a mighty warrior? I'm hiding from my enemy. I'm hiding in a wine press. Right? I'm busy hiding from my enemy. How can you call me a mighty warrior? But he did not know what God knew. You don't know what God knows. I don't know what God knows. All I know is that I need to believe him. That's all I know. It's all that I want to know. It's going to corrupt my mind if I know what's coming. So I'm quite happy to be with what I have. Because that's why he says, I must use what I have. I must do what I can with what I have. I must start now. And that's what I'm doing. And I'm going to say to you, and he says to Gideon, go in the strength that you have. Do you think that Gideon was very strong? No. Gideon was a bangaard. Hij was een mannetje wat weggesteek het. As die church is gekom, dat hy eerste, hy het sy vrou voor in die gestoot, en gaat keil in die achterkamer. Sê hy, vader, ja, jy klap moest van my bykie rond, so gaan klap jy maar die church is wat nou hier by ons deur staan. Nee, hy was een bangaard. Dis wat Gideon, maar nogtans sê die engel van God vir hom, gaan in jou kracht. In jou kracht. Met andere woorden, Krisma, sy kracht was maar min. Sy kracht was maar min. En misschien sit jy hier vanmorgen en jy denk by jouself, yo, Wesley, do you know where I am? Do you know me? I don't know you. But I know someone who knows you. I know somebody who knows you. He knows your heart and he knows the depth of your soul. He knows that. And he says to me, I must tell you that even that little strength that you have, you must stand up in that little strength because he's going to use that little strength to wipe out the entire Midianite army. In fact, you know why God thinned out the army? Because he didn't want Gideon's head to grow bigger. He wanted Gideon to remain humble and to give the glory to God. In fact, he called the army together and God said to him, no, you've got too many people. He says, no, you must be joking. We don't even have that many men. Because the Midianite army is huge. So he says, no, send them home. So hulle wat getrou het en wat probleme het, stuur hulle huis toe, ek wil hulle nie heen nie. En toe is hulle nog altijd te veel. Toe vat hulle af naar die rivier toe, toe sê vir Gideon, kyk hoe hulle die water drink daar. Wie van hulle op hulle hande vier voet en wie hulle hande gebruik om die water, en dan sal ek vir jou sê, wie om te kies. Toe is daar net 300 man oor. En die Heere gee vir hulle die oorwinning. En vriende, toe die Heere vir hulle die oorwinning gee, toe weet hulle dat dit was die Heere. Hulle het geweet, dit is die Heere. Is julle met my? Hulle kon nie sê, ja, maar dit was my kracht, my gedagtes, my geld, my kar, my trekte, my perd. Nee, hulle kon niks sê nie. Want hulle het geweet, sonder twyfel, dat dit was die Heere wat vir hulle die oorwinning gegee het. Vriende, dit is wat die Heere vir Krisma wil doen. He wants to give you the victory. He's already given you the victory, but he doesn't want you to take the glory. The glory belongs to him. Amen. Hallelujah. What did he say to the disciples? The disciples came. He says, Master, we don't have enough food for these people. Send them home that they can, or send them to the town to go and buy their own food. But Jesus says, no. Just let them all sit down. What have you got? They said, no, there's a little lad here who's got 2 fish and 5 loaves. 2 fish and 5 loaves. Wie gaan eet en wie gaan kyk? Wie gaan eet en wie gaan hulle lippe aflek en wie gaan eindelijk iets eet? This is the kind of situation that God is looking for because he can thrive on that. He can do things that you can't even think about he will do. Hallelujah. And then he said to them, bring, and you know what happened? There was 12 baskets of loaves left. Everybody ate, 5,000 men and their families ate, and there were still 12 baskets of bread left. Nou moet nie vir my vraag wat er gebeur met die visie, want die vis is kant en klaar. Right? Hulle was allemaal kapen daar, hulle hou van die vis. So dit is wat gebeur het. Maar ek wil vir julle sê, die onmoontlike, die Heere specialiseer in die onmoontlike, wat vir jou onmoontlik lyk, Krisma, is elke dag sy werkies vir die Heere. En daarom wil ek vir sê, what you have is enough. Maak vrede met dit. Maak vrede met die man wat jy het. Maak vrede met die kinders wat jy het. Al is hulle stoet. Al wil jy hulle wurg. Maak vrede met hulle.
Laat jij die hoer, you take the high road. Because you have the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. And they say, you have the strength, you have the money, you have the skill, you have the love, you have the wisdom, you have the knowledge. Why? Because you have the Word of God. You have it. Step out with that. Even if it is little, because God is going to be the difference. Hallelujah. Ek voel so maar lekker. Ek kyk, praat met myself en ek is bly daaroor. Omdat dit is wat die Here vir ons gee. Hallelujah. Nou, ek trek nou naar die einde toe. Ek wil net vir julle sê dat julle nie mismoedig raak nie. Ek wil nie julle moet opstaan en uitloop. So ek is nou klaar. Right, daar sê, twee gedagtes. Eerste gedagte is, put your doubts aside and focus on who you are in Christ. One of the biggest problems that you and I have is that we don't, doubt is a result of unbelief. Direct result. Moet ek. So nie kan ek reklaam, man. Dan weet sy hou van jou. Moet nie huiver nie. Maak jou, take the step of faith. Do what you must do. Doubt is going to be a big problem to you if you don't deal with it head on. We have one life to live, so live it. You know, ek was al in baie kerke, en ek moet julle sê, baie van die kerke wat ek in was, as ek na die ouderlinge kyk, dan denk ek met myself, oei, Here Jesus, ons het jou hulp nodig. Hieso. Want hulle lyk, voor hulle kerk toe kom in die oggende, dan kry hulle, gaan hulle in die tuin in, dan gaan plik hulle vir hulle paar suurlemoene, en dan suig hulle aan die suurlemoene, dan kom hulle so kerk toe. Dis die waarheid. Hulle, nie net as hulle gerimpel omdat hulle oud is nie, maar ook omdat hulle suurlemoene geëet het die oggend. Hulle verstaan nie wat die lewe is, om dat een mens die lewe moet geniet nie. Dit is die Heere wil hee, dat jy jou lewe moet lewe. In Him, of course. I don't need to have music and to have alcohol, to have a party. Ek sal soma nou begin, Jerusalem, sonder muziek. Ek het nie die muziek nodig om vir my in die buien te kry nie. Ek het die Heilige Gees in my. En ek het dit altyd vir my vriende gesê, toe ek groot word, ek het die hele drank nodig om gelukkig te wees, want ek is gelukkig. Ek het die Heilige Gees, ek sal soma dronk raak nou met die Heilige Gees, dat kan niemand van julle vir my stop, ek sal soma op die tafel staan en dans, en julle sal julle stikken lach, want ek kan nie eindelijk dans. Verstaan julle? So, die punt is, die Here het nie vir jou geroep om 'n suurknol te wees nie. Halleluja! Jy is nie een suurknol nie, jy is een persoon wat lewe in jou lichaam in het. My vrou klaar, dat daar groei hare uitplikke wat in die behoort te groei. Toe sê ek van, wees jy dankbaar, dat wys jou, ek is nog aan die lewe. Ek lewe. Ek is besig om te lewe. Ek wil lewe. Ek wil iets vir die Here beteken. So laat ek gaan, laat ek beweeg met die skare, dat ek vir hulle kan vertel van Jesus. Is julle met my? Asseblief, geen suurknolle hier nie. Julle is geregtig om by die huis te bly, julle kom hier en julle is gelukkig in Jesus. Halleluja. Time is short and it is limited. There is a need for an urgency of the heart. Today is unique and will never be repeated again. There is no day like today. And there you can see, there, we're not playing cricket or soccer, we are living life. We are living life. I'll never forget it. One guy, I was the best man to one of my friends. And this is the statement that the pastor said to him, my friend, I want to tell you, this marriage is not a practice run. This is not a practice run. This is life. Okay, and I want to say to you, this Christian life that you're living is not a practice run. You've got to live it. Seize the moment and do it. Okay, I want to end off with two words, just two words, the Lord really laid upon my heart. One is courage. We don't seize the moment. We do not carpe diem because of two things. One is courage, the lack of courage. Or people think that courage, when you, courage is not the absence of fear, right? We all have to deal with fear. Courage is not the lack of fear. You can ask anybody that has done courageous things. It's not because they were not afraid. They were afraid. Hulle was soma bang. Hulle broekies het maar gebewer. Maar ten spyte van dit, hulle nog steeds gedoen wat hulle moes gedoen het. Halleluja. En dit is wat ek vir julle wil bemoedig mee. Moenie dat vrees jou weerhou van dit wat die Here jou naartoe geroep het nie. Want het is nie, dit is 10% jy en 90% die Here. Of eindelijk is 1% jy en 99% die Here. It is moving and doing what you've been called to do despite of your fear. Halleluja. Die ander ene is die woord enthusiasm. En met dit wil ek sluit. I learned something completely new. I did not know. Enthusiasm means to have a real, a zestful life. Full of hope. Full of energy. Hope against hope. Despite the fact that we are down, we're not out. Soos die bekende spreekwoord sê, die Here sal nie 'n dowwe lamp uitblaas nie, né? Sê dit. Hope. You need hope. It comes, the word enthusiasm comes from the root word, entheos, which means from God. Entheos. Entheos, from God. So in other words, our enthusiasm, our hope, our life comes from God. He is the one that gives it to us. Hallelujah. And that is what I want to say to you. I have a dream and a vision. So let's move and let us do it. Carpe diem. Seize the moment. Just where you are, I want you just to bow your heads with me. I want to pray with you quickly. Doen dit nou. Dit is wat die Bybel sê. My vriende, familie in Christus, ek wil vir julle sê, daar is nie 'n tyd soos nou. Hierdie oomblikke voor die Here se troon is uniek. Dit is waar ons is. Jy is uniek. Dat die Here jou geroep het, dat die Here sy seun gestuur het om vir jou te sterwe op 'n kruis, op 'n houtkruis, is uniek. En daarom wil ek vir u bemoedig vanmôre. Ek gaan nie vanmôre vra dat jy jou hand opsteek of opstaan, nie. Maar wat ek wel wil hê jy moet doen, is in jou hart, wil ek hê jy moet saggies bid tot ons God, en vir hom sê, Here, help my, dat ek in hierdie oomblikke, 'n besluit sal maak, dat ek sal spring, dat ek sal intree, in die posisie, wat u reeds vir my voorberei het. There is a cloud of witnesses surrounding us this morning. In heaven, the angels and the saints that has gone before us, and many other believers across the world, they are standing with us as a witness that God has done everything for us. He has blessed us. He has determined the times and the places for us to live. He has given us His word. He has given us His spirit. And He is saying to you today, do not let this opportunity pass you by. but grab it with both your hands so that you can step into the purposes of God for your life. It doesn't matter where you find yourself. It doesn't matter how much you have in your hand. All that is needed is just a spark of hope, a spark of faith, a little bit of faith. Faith as small as a mustard seed. And God will perform miracles with that little seed. And I want you just to pray. Say, Lord, I am so blessed. Ek is so bevoorreg, Here, vanmôre hier te wees en te luister na jou woord. Ek is so bevoorreg, Here, dat U U seun gestuur het om vir my te kom sterwe op die kruis, op 'n houtkruis. Ek is so bevoorreg, Here, dat U U gees nagelaat het om binne in my te kom woon. Ek is so bevoorreg, Here, dat U my tegemoet kom in elke situasie in my lewe. En vanmôre gee ek my lewe weer eens na U. En vra, Here, help my dat ek in die perfekte sirkel van U wil sal wees. Help my dat ek carpe diem, dat ek die geleenthede sal gebruik wat U vir my skep. Father, I say thank you this morning for Christmas fellowship. Thank you, Lord, for all the things that you have purposed for this place, for this people. I ask, Lord, that you will bless them more than they can ever think. Your word says, do you not know, do you not understand that the blessings of God will lead us to repentance? And to bring us into the perfect will of God. And I want to say to you, Christmas Fellowship, you are blessed in the precious and mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.